For the past 10 years, Republicans and Democrats
have let us down.
That's why this year
I'm doing something different.
I'm giving the two-party system the third finger.
The third finger.
The third finger.
I'm Trey Davis, and I approve this message because it's time to give Washington the third finger, man.
That was former jam band frontman Trey Davis, who just won a surprise victory last night in his bid for U.S. Congress as an independent, a campaign that some saw as one of the least legitimate in Ohio's history.
I am for the people, like Bob Dylan said. God bless the people, man.
Man, I don't live by that shadow, and anyway, I'm better than him, right? I'm fucking better than you, Dad. I'm better than you, Pops. You hear that, Pops? Can I get a copy of this?
That, of course, is Bobby Ross, Davis's campaign manager and son of former Ohio State Senator Bob Ross, who was arrested twice last year for chaining himself to trees that were already cut down.
Save the trees! Save the trees! I'm not gonna stop yelling! You stop yelling!
And yet, last fall, Ross helped Davis get elected to city council in their hometown of Independence, Ohio, with a campaign showcasing Trey's jam band and a promise of Tree Hug Thursdays.
The other candidates are not for the people, man.
Yeah!
And I am for the people,
yeah,
man.
Okay, but specifically, you know, how does that differ you? What are your platforms? Circle back to that.
You go and circle back to your Illuminati media overlords before you start sandbagging my candidate?
Davis won the seat by less than 30 votes and used the experience this year to launch his congressional campaign against Republican incumbent Pat Healey and his Democratic challenger Dan King. And late last night, Davis somehow pulled off the impossible to become the next and first independent congressman to represent Ohio's 19th district. This was surely due to the incredible scandal that broke last week when both Congressman Healey and Democrat Dan King were caught on video in a homosexual act at a local hotel in the district.
Oi, get out of here! Get out of here! I'm a congressman! Right, get out of here!
Now, with the surprising results being uncontested by Ohio's GOP, this means Mr. Davis is going to Washington. To assemble his staff, he's hired famed Washington spin doctor Jay Taylor as his press secretary.
He's independent, he's young, he's fresh. We make a great pair. You've got a great pair. Can we do that again? I'm sorry about that. Hi.
Davis has also hired controversial D.C. political hitman turned advisor Nate Rosenberg. Rosenberg was reportedly hired this morning after responding to a Craigslist ad posted by Davis looking for people with government experience, man.
For the money. That's why I'm doing this. I don't have any feelings about this. I have a PhD in political science from Brown, and I've spent 15 years on the Hill. Ha! Yeah! Can we skip ahead about the part that this is just for the money? Okay? I'm done with you. Goodbye.
Ah! This place. God damn it.
As one of the only independent congressmen in American history, Davis is already becoming something of a DC celebrity.
This land is your land. This land is my land.
How do you think I should wear my swearing in?
Damn it.
Hey, Jay.
Jay, man, what are you doing?
What? I'm sorry, my ex-wife's the worst.
She keeps sending me pictures of her boyfriend's dick on Draw Something.
How's it look?
Like a 2-liter bottle of Coke.
That's great. Hey, can you help me decide what tie to wear my swearing in? I'm trying to pick between this American colored tie or my favorite dinosaur tie.
Well, the American dream has been dead for years, just like the dinosaurs, so gotta go with that tie.
Boom, you nailed it, man. Boy, I am glad we hired you. You are great.
No, you're great.
No, you're great.
No, you're great.
No, you're great.
You're great.
No, you're great.
No, you're great.
No, you're great.
No, you're great. Let me see that foggy bottom.
Huh?
Yeah, let me see inside that beltway.
No.
Come on, give me a little kiss. Let me get inside that beltway. Come on, get over here.
No,
I'm just kidding. I love you. Hey, kiss me on the tip of the Washington Monument.
Come on.
Yeah, just a little bit. Come on. Get on Santa's lap. Come on, baby boy. Can people do that?
Yeah, is that what Washington is all about?
Just on the tip.
Let's take the elevator all the way up.
Lily!
Hey!
Strom Thurmond would have worn both of those ties.
Well, I gotta be more like Strom Thurmond.
Who's he?
I don't know.
I need to tell you that Nate's outside. He says he needs to speak to you.
Yeah, sure. Send him in.
Good. Because you know how those Polacks can get when you keep them waiting.
Is she a little racist?
I'm a little racist. She's a lot racist.
Mm. Keep her around.
Yeah, she's fun.
All right.
Oh, man.
Oh, hey, Nate.
Shut the fuck up.
All right.
Look, we've got to get to the point. You have got to change your image now.
Bro, what's wrong with my image, man? All right, I said I was going to stay me, all right? And that's what I'm going to do, right? That's why I got so much incense all over the office.
Yeah, man, spark another one up, Congressman.
Yeah, lavender.
Look, you have to understand. You are in a very divided house right now. Now, there's a good chance both the Republicans and the Democrats are going to want your vote. This is an opportunity. But if you misuse it, people are going to be digging up a lot of dirt on you.
Dude, we don't have any dirt on us, man. We are clean and cool.
I did a background check on you, and I found out a lot of very incriminating shit about you and Bobby. I assume you read the folder?
I mean, I don't know, man. I got a lot of folders here. And I told you, I'm not ashamed of anything we've done.
Any of this stuff could be a giant scandal. There's, like, insane shit in here. May 2001, you were caught smoking marijuana in a synagogue.
Found out about that one, huh?
I can spin it. You're pro-health, pro-Israel.
Boom, spun.
June 2007, you threw a vegan burrito at an off-duty FBI agent.
I was trying to feed it to him.
Pro-local farms, pro-police benefits.
Spin it, spun it, spun.
January 2009, you helped a 150-pound turtle escape from the Columbus Zoo, and then you accidentally ran it over with your car. March 2007, you assaulted the drummer from Hootie and the Blowfish.
God, that fucker.
July 2002, you poisoned a Holocaust survivor.
Well, okay, what was she doing that rave, and why didn't she tell me she was already on ecstasy?
The list goes on and on. There are 6 more incidents of you assaulting other members of Hootie and the Blowfish.
Yeah. I mean, that band. Yeah, I mean, come on. That's, I mean, 1998 was
a shitty band, man. I mean, I think people will be cool.
And your chief of staff, Bobby, his track record makes yours look tame. Are you guys fucking retarded? Where is Bobby? I left one of those on his desk, too.
Look, Bobby had an interview with the Washington Post lady. I'm sure he got the folder, and I'm sure everything's gonna be fine.
I'll be honest, Janice, there's 2 likely scenarios here. Either chemtrails or jet streams that are caused by airplanes.
Yeah, right.
Or they are small dosages of Valium dropped by the government to control the people of the United States. And that is gonna be the first congressional speech that I have Trey make.
Well, it sounds like you're getting a lot done.
Yeah, we do get things done, but we also have fun. You want to see something crazy?
Okay.
Today I found a list of all the crazy shit that Trey and I have done over the years on my desk.
Amazing.
I gotta read you some of this. This is off the record, right? Oh, cool, cool. All right. Okay, September 2004, I was caught wearing blackface at a middle school production of Dreamgirls.
Wow.
I don't remember that.
Wow. That's really?
Nuts. Yeah, you gotta get the rest of it. February 2004, me and Trey were caught smoking weed out of the shell of a 150-pound turtle we just hit with our car.
Amazing. Really?
That was crazy. Yeah, oh, May 2005, I burned a crossing guard's fanny pack at a 9/11 memorial. That was radical. Okay.
Unbelievable.
Hey, you know what? Let's finish the rest of this over lunch.
Okay, I'd love to. Yeah. Let's
great,
go.
Great. I can't wait to tell you about the time we accidentally hosted a KKK rally in our basement.
Wow.
Crazy, right? A lot of linens lost that day.